Since you're watching this video, I guess your computer is experiencing this error as you're trying to open a program you've recently installed. This error arrived. The program can start because xcd_audio1_5.dll is missing from your computer. It's a very common issue, and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and follow that method on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So let's get started. At first, open your favorite browser and search for xcd_audio1_5.dll. You can choose any result you want. In this case, I'll be choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see few download options based on the architecture and version. To know your PC architecture and version, click on Start and search for system information. There you go. You can see mine is 64-bit and I'm updated to recent Windows update. So in this case, I'll be downloading the second one. I strongly recommend you to read this phase. It can be useful for a backup process also. As the download complete, hit open. You can see the DLL file in the folder. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then new volume C, Windows, and find a folder named system32. This is the home of 32-bit DLL files. Then click on the downloaded zip, drag the DLL and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace. And click on continue to give administrator access. Before we go ahead, let's check. By typing the entire file name, you can see the file is placed in 32-bit folder. So the missing error for 32-bit user should be gone. Only if you are a 64-bit users, open this PC one more time, local disk C, Windows, and this time find a folder named syswow64. This is the home of 64-bit DLL files, and similarly drag and drop. In short, 64-bit users need to place the file in both 32-bit folder and 64-bit folder. Check this one more time. Yeah, you can see the file is placed where it was has been missing. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download and install the latest Microsoft DirectX from Microsoft official website and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problem left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.